We'll be bringing you the YTV Achievement Awards, sponsored by Popsicle Industries and their dairy partners, Human Resources Development Canada, Stay in School, and the A&E Network. The YTV Achievement Awards, Saturday, April 16th at 7:30.
Introducing Magic Works. No-fail magic you can master in minutes.
This, my friends, is clean cut. I will magically cut a solid piece of rope and put it back together.
Give me that. It's real.
Watch closely. I place the rope into this magical holder, cut.
Just cut.
And magically restore it like new.
Wow! That's unbelievable!
That's impossible.
That's right. It's magic.
Clean cut comes with everything you see here. Other tricks in the Magic Works collection sold separately.
All right, what's up? We're here live on The Zone, and we will be going to a clip very soon. I got about a minute to tell you about it, but I went to the Dome, and I went and visited, saw a game, an exhibition game, and Robbie Alomar, because we're like this, left me a ticket, so it was pretty cool. So we're going to show that right before the Junior J show, which is going to be happening at 6 p.m. Eastern, right after after this clip that I show you. Has a lot of fun stuff. I am in it. Ashna is in it. We do a lot of spring training stuff. We went down to Dunedin, visited. We talked to guys like Joe Carter, John Olerud, Galen Sisko, the pitching coach, and we do a lot of fun stuff. And all has to do with the Junior Jays coming up at 6 p.m. So before we waste any more time, I'm going to tell you, here we go. I basically went to the Dome. Robbie gave me a ticket, and I go and hang out, and I get the best seat in the house. All right. And if you're smart, you know that this is all wrong, and I'm probably not going to get the best seat. I'm going to be an idiot again, the clown of the whole thing. So without further ado, we are going to throw it down to this clip. And I will be in the Zone tomorrow, but special. I go and play, you know. I want to tell you, I got a surprise, because tomorrow's a holiday, even though I have to work. But I have something planned special for the Zone tomorrow. But we will be here tomorrow, and everybody, we'll see you later. What's up? Listen to this. It's The Zone. And I'm here for Toronto Blue Jays' first home game of the season. It's an exhibition game. And me and Roberto Alomar, we're like this. We're tight. And he left me one of these beauties. This is like the ticket of like the best seat in the place. So I'm going to go in. I'm going to see the game. I'm going to have a good time. Let's check it out. Hi. I'm here for the game. Robbie Alomar left me this ticket. It's like the good seat ticket. We're like this, you know.
Okay, I'm sorry, sir, but it's down the corridor and up the ramp. Up the ramp?
Oh, they must have changed the Dome. Because, like, the field level is usually down. Oh, yeah, me and Robbie, we go way back. We studied a lot of the same subjects together. You know, me and Robbie. Yeah, well, yeah, Roberto Alomar, me and him.
Your tickets.
Oh, sure.
And that's 500 level? You just booked this ramp right here, up to the 500 level.
Oh.
Enjoy the game.
Well, I'll see you later then.
Yeah, see ya.
Enjoy the game. Hi.
Hi there.
I think I'm sitting here.
Yeah? Okay, yeah, you're up to the top of the row here.
Are you sure I'm not like in the VIP? Roberto Alomar owes me a dinner for this. Okay, it's not the best seat in the house, but listen to this. If you do want the best seat in the house, all you have to do is tune in to the Junior Jays TV magazine. It's a spring training edition. We're talking like backstage pass to all behind-the-scenes stuff in Dunedin and Toronto here on YTV. You're definitely going to check that out. Dr. J's in the house, and I'm in the house in the Dome here, and I'm having a good time. All right. 3, 2, 1.
Now a message from the Power Rangers.
Damn, you gonna let that dweeb get away with that?
Tony, man, look what this wimp did to your new sneaks.
Hey, what's up with that? Fight!
You gotta stop those hotheads.
Fight!
Come on, guys, knock it off.
Hey,
Hey, let me go.
Weren't doing anything.
Think not? Let's watch that again.
Let's remove you two from the picture.
Without you cheering them into that fight, Tony and Adam could have worked out their differences.
Hey, man, let me get that for you. Two more drinks, please.
Think you might handle it differently now?
Let's put you two back in the picture.
Chill, Tony!
He didn't mean it.
Cut him some slack, Adam. It was an accident.
Cool.
Hey, all you wave jammers, cruise over to the coolest game around. Check it out before you commit and learn how to score big. Challenge the future now. Turn on Video at Arcade, Mondays 6:30 p.m., Saturdays 12:30. There's only one law of survival in this jungle, his. Swing into adventure with Tarzan, Saturdays at 7:30 on YTV. The boys of summer are warming up for another hot season, and Junior J's TV magazine will be right there getting tips from the pros.
For you to get to the major league level, you're gonna have to put in your time.
Go behind the bleachers and meet the real heroes.
I can remember when I was as young as 7 or 8 years old, dreaming about things like that. And yeah, I'm here to tell you that dreams do come true.
Catch YTV's Junior J's TV magazine next. The following is a YTV special presentation. Brought to you by Hubba Bubba. It's outrageous. It's original. It's the official gum of the Junior Jays. Junior J's TV Magazine with PJ Phil and PJ Ashna, and hosted by Dr. J.
Ooh. Hi, I'm Dr. J. Welcome to the second edition of YTV's Junior J's TV Magazine. Outside, the sky is blue, the wind is warm, the trees are budding, the birds are singing, and it's spring. And in spring, in Canada, the thoughts of every boy and girl, of every young man and every young woman turn to spring training. And spring training means the Blue Jays, the back-to-back World Series champions, getting ready for the new season in Dunedin, Florida. My YTV crew went to Dunedin and talked to Blue Jays like Joe Carter and John Olerud. They met some Blue Jay coaches and got tips on batting and pitching. We're going to show you how to pick the right glove and the right bat, and we're going to talk to Junior Jays about their favorite Blue Jays and their favorite characters from the Junior Jays magazine. And speaking of the magazine, join me and all the members of the Junior Jays baseball team, including Ben, Ashley, and Crunchy, in our new adventures in the Spring 94 edition of Junior Jays magazine. Just ask your police officer who visits your school for your copy. Now, let's find out about Dunedin and that part of Florida where the Blue Jays go for spring training.
Every year, thousands of Canadians travel to the Tampa Bay area of Florida, where Dunedin, the Blue Jays' winter home, is located. There's lots to see and do in Florida. But the big attraction, besides the Blue Jays, is the sun and the beach.
Blue Jays this year. Can't miss. We need another pitcher. Hey. Saber Hagen's on the way. The Mets don't need him.
All the way, eh?
Go, Jays, go!
Each March, thousands of university students come down to Clearwater Beach for spring break.
Go, Blue Jays!
Good luck, Blue Jays!
In Dunedin, the Blue Jays loosen up and get ready for another day of spring training.
Woo! Welcome, Florida.
Sunshine, blue skies. Where is it? I don't know.
Dr. J's Trivia File is brought to you by Hubba Bubba. In 1993, how many days off did the Blue Jays get during the regular season? Answer, 16 days.
Now, we all know it was the Blue Jays' fantastic hitting that helped them win back-to-back World Series. Now, Blue Jays batting coach Larry Heisel told us what it takes to be a major league hitter.
With professional sports, and especially baseball, the one thing that is a given is you have to learn how to deal with defeat. To me, that is probably the biggest asset a professional athlete can have, because 7 out of 10 at bats is almost guaranteed for most athletes to be failures. So I always tell even our major league players that you have to pencil in at least twice throughout the course of the season some disappointment. And the key is how you deal with that. I always tell our players, and there's a couple of major league players I'm telling this to almost to this exact moment. The last thing you tell yourself before you go to bed and the first thing in the morning is that this is going to be the best year of my career. And you also tell yourself that about 1,000 times throughout the course of the day. With our players, also the younger players, I'm real big on goal setting. We've discussed goal setting actually almost from the first day. The biggest thing, though, that I try to do is just make players be a realist. Make sure that if you come out here and you give an honest effort day in and day out, you know, normally the best will happen. But if for some reason it doesn't, the challenge becomes even greater. If you go 0 for 4 or 0 for 8, then you want to come back that next day with more determination than ever.
It looks so easy when the Blue Jays do it, but when you try it yourself, it takes a lot of skill. Figuring out a player's batting average is a lot easier than hitting a baseball. It takes a little math, but we can handle that. Now, let's say a player has been up to bat 4 times and he's only hit 2 times. That means he's hit half the times and he's got a 500 batting average. Nobody's ever hit that well in the major leagues, but John Olerud has come close. At the beginning of last August, his batting average was 402, and he ended the season with an average of 363, the best in the American League.
Last spring training, could I have dreamed I would have had this year? No, I really couldn't have. I know coming into last year, I wanted to get as well prepared as I could to have a good year, and I felt like in years past, that I was capable of putting together a good year, but just didn't work out. I'd have a bad streak early in the year, or something would happen to where I wouldn't really put it all together. And I was hoping to have a real consistent year, and got off to a good start in spring training. I was hitting real well, and was hoping that I wouldn't use up all my hits in spring training. And fortunately enough, I got off to a good start early in the year, and it just kept going. And it was just a lot of fun. And I think if you do the physical preparation, that's something that you definitely need. And then mentally, when you get down here, just got to relax, have fun, and work on what it's going to take to help you be successful. And last year, I had a good year, and so I have an idea of what it's going to take to have a good year. And so hopefully I'll be able to, put everything together again. I think you measure your success, you got to look at yourself. I think everybody has a little bit of pride, likes to do a job well done, and how hard and how much effort you put into things. And I think that's the big thing, how hard you work at it, because you're going to have successes and you're going to fail, but I think you can look at it as a success based on how hard you work at it.
Everyone needs a good warm-up before the game. It gets the heart beating, the blood moving, and wakes up every little part of your body. Tommy Craig, the Blue Jays trainer, told us how to warm up properly and prevent injury.
I'm Tommy Craig, head trainer for the Blue Jays. I've been with them now about 15 years, and this is my 8th year in the big leagues. I think it's very important for anyone to warm up before they do any exercise. I guess a good thing keep it simple would be go out and do a light jog, a 5-minute jog. The old adage is you warm up to play, you don't play to warm up. Some of the more simpler stretches we do prior to going out and warming up our arms or prior to a game, you start right across in front with horizontal abduction, blocking with your right arm across the front and your left held in front of that for resistance. You're going to stretch the posterior shoulder right back in here. Another one we do is straight up overhead. Grab the top tip of your elbow and just pull it over towards your head. And just hold again for 15 to 20 seconds. Then we may go just straight up overhead, lock your hands, come up overhead, and then just try to separate your arm. There's one important muscle that we haven't mentioned yet, and that's the heart, right here. And I think smoking attacks that harder than anything. Your heart and lungs are very important, a vital system. And if you smoke and cause your heart muscle to deteriorate, or you're not taking in the proper amount of oxygen because of smoking, it can affect every system in your body.
All right, I hope you're enjoying the show, and we're coming up to a commercial pretty soon, so I wanted to get some snacks. Now, I wanted to tell you about realignment, because, you know, I'm studying something, and it always helped me when I wrote it on the fridge. Now, the American League is getting a whole new look this year. This is what they looked like last year. In the Eastern Division, we had Toronto. We had Baltimore, New York, Cleveland, Detroit, Boston, and Milwaukee. In the West, we had Chicago, Seattle, Kansas City, California, Minnesota, Texas, and Oakland. What they did was they created the Central Division, all right? They took two teams from the East, three teams from the West, made a Central Division. Now, this is what the American League looks like now. In the East, we have Toronto, Baltimore, New York, Boston, Detroit. And in the Central Division, we have Chicago, Cleveland, Kansas City, Milwaukee, and Minnesota. The West now looks like this. Texas, Seattle, Oakland, and California. Now, everybody plays everybody during the regular season, we know that. But the big question is, who plays who in the postseason, you know, in the playoffs? So this is what's gonna happen. First place in the East, first place in the Central Division, and first place in the West, and a wild card team. Now, what that is the team with the next best record out of all three divisions gets this fourth spot in the playoffs. And what this means to me is postseason will last forever. All right, and it also means Toronto's gonna beat these guys, Toronto's gonna beat these guys, Toronto's gonna beat the wild card team, and let me tell you, it will be a three-peat in 94. Oh yeah.
We'll be right back with Blue Jays catcher Randy Knorr and some baseball safety tips.
Joanne, let me take your hand, try to understand, I will always care.
Smoking, it will suck the life right out of you.
His favorite team has returned.
Look at the lineup we have coming back. Rick Wild Thing Vaughn, catcher and team leader Jake Taylor, veteran third baseman Roger Dorr, also back is Willie Mays Hayes, and he's out by an eyelash at third. Boy, we never seem to get the close ones.
Major League 2.
Now playing at a theater near you.
Jet formation!
Jet transformation!
The aerial bots are taking their shots. Some of both plastic combaticons. They can all change and be rearranged to form a super robot Superion. The combaticons are roaring, Einstein is roaring. Here's one metamorph in Duricus. They all combine and kick Superion's behind as a big bad battle in Bruticus.
Now we're brutal.
No, that's Bruticus.
Transformer Generation 2 aerial bots and combaticons each sold separately.
You're getting very greedy. You are me, Wario. You're very handsome. You have amazing powers. Plunder and pillage pirate's treasure. Bag a bazillion coins. Buy me a castle bigger than Mario's. Repeat after me. I'm the bad guy in Wario Land, Super Mario Land 3, where being bad is good and greed is good.
System and game sold separately.
It's on Game Boy, greedy.
Baseball is a lot of fun, and it's even more fun if you play it safely and use the right protective equipment. Randy Knorr, one of the Blue Jays' catchers, took time off from spring training to tell us about the catcher's special protective equipment.
Okay, when you catch, it's important to have the proper equipment. We'll start from the bottom and we'll work our way up. Here they have on the shin guards. First of all, the shin guards go up to your knee all the way down to your ankle. And that's to protect you when you're catching, to protect you from getting foul tips on your knees or on your shins, which would hurt a lot if you didn't have it on. This part down here is over for the top of your foot, because when they do hit the foul tips, it would hit you on the top of the foot if you didn't have it. A long time ago, they didn't have it. They just started using it, and it does save my feet a little bit. As you move up here, always remember when you catch to wear the cup. That's the first thing you need to know. The chest protector, that's also for the foul tips, and you need all this protection in front of you, because when you're in front of the ball like that, the foul tip or the ball's in the dirt will hit you in the chest, so you need a protector to protect your chest. Then you got your helmet. The guy swings, and the backswing comes, it'll hit you in the top of the head, and you don't want that. So you get the helmet, you got to turn the helmet around, and then comes the mask. So here's your mask. You need your mask, again, for the foul tips, and you want to keep your beautiful face, so you need to put the mask on. And, of course, the glove. You need the glove to catch.
Bob Baylor, the Blue Jays' first base coach, played professional baseball for 16 seasons, 11 of those seasons in the major leagues. That's a lot of spring training. So Bob was just the guy to tell us what spring training is like for both the veterans and rookie Blue Jays.
Well, spring training is different to different people. You have your veteran players who come down who know what they have to do to get in shape. They know they have the team made. What they do, they kind of ease into it. And what they try to do is, at the end of spring training, be peaked, so to speak. So when the season starts, they are in a good groove and ready to go. Now you get to your middle of the line player who doesn't have a chance of making the club. Well, he better peak early, because he's what you'd call on the bubble. Either he makes the club or he doesn't. So for him, it's important to get off to a good start and hopefully make the club. And then you go to your young guys who, are probably A-ball, double-A players who are here more or less for the experience of it, what it's like to be in a major league spring training camp. Virtually have no chance of making the club, but the experience is going to help them down the line. Well, you start in A-ball, which is usually a full league. You play 140 games. Then you go to double-A ball, triple-A ball, and hopefully to the sky dome.
My name's Sean Green, 21, California. I'm a right fielder. Last year I played in Knoxville in double-A.
My name is Howard Battle. I'm 21 years old. I played at Knoxville double-A last year, and I'm a third baseman.
My name is Paul Spaljerik. I'm from Kelowna, British Columbia. I'm a left-handed pitcher, and hopefully I can be here this year.
Hello, my name is Carlos Delgado. I play for the Jays. I'm a catcher. I'm from Puerto Rico, hometown Aguadilla. I'm 21 years old. I played in Knoxville, Tennessee in the Southern League last year.
My name is Alex Gonzalez. I'm 20 years old. I was born in Miami, and I played shortstop for Toronto. Played in Double-A in Knoxville last year.
Time for Hubba Bubba's Junior Jays Trivia File. What Blue Jay coach played for the Jays in their first season? The answer, Bob Baylor.
Did you ever wonder what makes a good bat and what makes it right for you? I did, and here's what I found out.
Well, at Louisville Slugger, all bats are made out of white ash. White ash has a nice combination of strength, resiliency, and lightweight. Some companies have used hardwoods in the past. The problem with the hardwood, it dents and it has a tendency to chip. They're very light, but they dent and they do chip. I think one of the most important things is finding a bat that has proper balance. Buying a bat that is too long or too short certainly won't help their swing. Buying a bat that's too heavy certainly won't help their swing. Just like a pro ball player, the lighter the bat, the faster they can swing it. So you have to have a proper balance. You have to have a proper swing weight. So you find that with the youth, usually they're buying bats that are too heavy and sometimes too long. So try and tailor your bat to what your swing speed is going to be. What a ball player looks for in a bat when he pulls them out of the box, he looks for the straight grain. Not so much that the grain is thick or thin, although ball players will tell you that most guys like the wider grains. It gives them a better feel. The thinner grain usually means it's a harder bat. So the ball player looks down that barrel to make sure that grain is proper. The other thing to look for is a straight grain through the handle. Because when a wooden bat breaks, it usually breaks right along this area right here. Okay? So a ball player looks at that bat and you say, hey, that's pretty good through the handle area. So there won't be any breakage. So when that bat breaks, it'll break usually right through here. You've heard the story about keeping the label up on a bat. Well, that's true, because the label, this is the weakest part of the bat. So what a ball player, when he hits, is gonna hit along here, or he hit along here. This is the strongest part of his bat. This is the model that Joe Carter hit the game-running home run with in Game 6 of the World Series. In fact, his bat's in the Hall of Fame right now.
Life is full of ups and downs and all arounds. Life is also full of a lot of decisions and choices. I have to make choices every day, like what music to play on my guitar, or what guests to have on my show, or what food to eat, you know, junk food or health food. Now, the only person that should make a decision for you is you, like who to hang out with, or when to do your homework, or making sure that you get a good night's sleep so you feel good the next day. Some decisions are hard, though, like, say, drugs. People try and tell you that drugs are cool, even though you know in your gut that it's not. All I'm saying is, use your head. Do what's right for you, you know? Besides, there are a lot of things you can do with your time that are a lot more fun. So remember, the ball is in your field.
Here it is. I got it. The stories in this new spring edition of the Junior Jays magazine are fantastic. Ashmead and Nicolette get a job babysitting, and when the parents go out, well, you won't believe what happens to them. Junior Jays across the country are getting ready for this new issue, and our PJ Ashna talks to one of them in Brampton, Ontario.
We're hanging out with John Michael, who is a Junior Jay member and is 12 years old, and we're in Brampton, chilling out in your room. Now, how did you become a Junior Jay member?
From my school. That's where I got the sign-out form, and I think the police brought it to me.
Did you ever write a letter to Dr. J?
Yes, I wrote a letter to Dr. J, and I talked about my brothers and my sisters and my friends at school and how I liked the Blue Jays and the Junior Jays and how this club was really cool.
What do you like about the Junior J magazines?
It's how they travel a lot and how they play baseball all the time, because I like to play baseball too.
Who's your favorite member of the Junior Jays baseball team?
Ben. Ben's the best.
How come?
Because he's always rough and he always plays baseball good and he travels a lot too with the Junior Jays.
What's it like going to a Blue Jays game?
It's awesome. Just the crowd makes you roar, and I want to catch a ball at the game too because it's awesome. And I got Paul Molitor's autograph and Dick Schofield's autograph last year when we went to see the exhibition game. They were playing the Dodgers, but they lost.
Who's your favorite Blue Jay?
Roberto Alomar. He's best.
Why is he the best?
Because he's a really good defensive player, and he can hit too, and he's a really good role model.
What would you say to Robbie Alomar if you could see him and talk to him?
I'd tell him that I'm a real big fan of his and that I'd love to have his autograph and that I'd love to have his rookie card.
How do you think the Blue Jays are going to do this year?
They're going to win again. They're going to win again. They're the best team in the whole league.
If you want to write to Dr. J, just send a letter to Dr. J, care of Junior J's, P.O. Box 6, Toronto, Ontario, M4A2M8.
Every single cigarette.
Take up smoking if you want to. Just know what you're getting into. Smoking, it'll suck the life right out of you.
Hey, stick it! Nappy! Stick it! Come on, stick it to him, stick it to him, stick it! Nappy! Stick it! Come on, stick it to him, stick it to him, stick it!
The Nerf Sharpshooter.
Each Nerf Sharpshooter sold separately with three darts.
The Nerf NB1 is so explosive, so intense, and so powerful, its only limits are your wildest dreams. NB1, it's Nerf or nothing.
Each sold separately.
Treasure rocks have a sparkling treasure inside.
Put treasure rocks in the magic revealer, and in about a minute, you turn rocks into jewels.
Wow.
What kind of jewels did you get? Then you can make whole sets of glittering jewelry.
Treasure rocks.
I've got more treasure rocks. Let's do the rest.
Treasure rocks have a sparkling treasure inside.
Treasure rocks jewelry sets each come with 12 rocks, each sold separately.
All across the country. Here's one from Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island. Dear Dr. J, my name is Linda, and I love your magazine. I hope you can answer a question for me. Why do the Blue Jays have to go to spring training in Florida? Well, Linda, baseball teams have been going to spring training for a very long time. When all the teams were in the northeastern part of the United States, going to Florida gave them a place to practice where they didn't have to worry about the cold weather. Now it's become a tradition. Here's another letter from Mike in Saskatoon. Hi, Dr. J. I'm a pitcher for our Little League baseball team, and I'd really like to pitch for the Major Leagues someday. What can I do to help make myself a better pitcher? Okay, Mike. Here's Galen Sisko, the Blue Jays pitching coach, and Dave Stewart, the Blue Jays great right-hander, to tell you what it takes to be a winning major league pitcher.
The mental attitude, as far as the pitcher goes, is probably as important as the physical attributes. I know that you must prepare for games, and the physical part of it will come.
Oh, I'm probably using 80% mental and 20% physical ability out there now.
As pitchers or as infielders or outfielders, catchers, you have to take it day by day. Work hard every day because it's not an easy game to play on a professional level.
I still think the best pitch in baseball is fastball. So that's my lead pitch, and I still consider it to be my out pitch. You need to show hitters something different every now and then as a first pitch. So I have what I call a get-over curveball. It's not a sharp breaking pitch, but you know, just good enough to throw for a strike first pitch. You're not going to try to strike anybody out with it, which is what I predominantly use it for.
There's a definite reason why a curveball pitch curves, and that is because of the spin that a pitcher puts on the ball. A pitch will break according to the spin, and if it's overspin, it'll break down. Of course, if it has side rotation on it, it'll be kind of flat, breaking sideways. I think pitchers, especially younger kids below 16, 17 years old, should not even worry about breaking balls. To me, they should concentrate more on fastballs and more on changeups because the tendons are not really set in their arms, and it's very destructive to tendons in your arm if you throw breaking pitches too early. What makes a good changeup is making it look like a fastball, and so your arm speed has to be the same as it is on the fastball. The grip takes the speed off the ball, so you know, it's so difficult to throw a changeup and to get that grip. You know, kids want instant success these days, but throwing changeups are not easily to come by. You have to work on it every day, diligently, day in and day out, like our major league pitchers do.
You have to remember that baseball is a game. And so even though you consider it to be a game, there's a certain degree of work that's involved. And for you to get to the major league level, you're going to have to put in your time, you know, do your work, do a little extra, and if you can commit yourself to doing that, you have a good chance to be a major league player.
Everybody remembers Al Leiter's outstanding performance in Game 1 of the 1993 World Series when he pitched nearly three innings of shutout ball to lead the Blue Jays to an 8-5 victory. But people forget that Al faced and overcame a lot of problems to get that victory.
It's been about 3 years on and off. I was traded in 89 for Jesse Barfield, of which after I started one game and I hurt my arm. Kind of persevered through a lot of setbacks. I had two shoulder operations. I had a blister problem that got some notoriety and just some down times. And I think I'm a good example of not giving up. I mean, I always persevered and I believed in myself. I think it's very important in this game particularly. There's a lot of people telling you what you can't do. And as long as you believe in yourself, even in all walks of life, and have the confidence in knowing that you can handle any type of job, which in my case is pitching, certainly you will overcome. And with the hard work and motivation and dedication that I had to do to get my arm ready and mentally prepare myself accordingly to get back to the major leagues, I did it. The last 2 years was a successful, healthy season for me, and certainly last year being part of a world championship team and helping the way that I did, it was a dream come true. The whole year, really. I mean, to look back at my last 3 or 4 years with the Blue Jays, to put in the type of season that I did, it was a dream. And so, you know, I didn't focus on one individual accomplishment. Actually, there was a moment in the World Series against John Crook that I struck him out with bases loaded and basically really helped win that game. And a lot of reporters after the game were saying, was that your biggest moment? It really wasn't. My biggest moment was the second game of the season in Seattle when I pitched 7 innings, a 2-hit shutout ball. It was my first win in 4 years when I was with the Yankees in 1989 in April. So that was a bigger accomplishment because it was the culmination of all that hard work and dedication, knowing what it took to get back. I think, you know, if you believe in what you dream for and strive for and really focus on that type of direction, I believe, I mean, you can do it. I mean, of course, there's got to be, in this game, you have to have some physical talents that maybe, you know, God or somebody gave you, but other than that, working hard and dedicating and believing in yourself.
Junior J's Trivia File is brought to you by Hubba Bubba. How many stitches are there in an official Major League Baseball? The answer is 108 stitches.
Mine, all mine! Besides getting in shape and sharpening up all their baseball skills, Blue Jays at spring training are also deciding on their equipment for the coming season. And one of the most important pieces of equipment for every baseball player is his glove.
I'm in spring training to help outfit the Blue Jays with a product called Zet Baseball Equipment, which we're the Canadian distributors for up in Canada. We've got several players right now, Dwayne Ward, Mike Timlin, who wear the glove.
The big person on our product catalog is Roger Clemens. A lot of the pros, some pros like to have an open back, which is like this, with just one strip of leather going up the top, and then another pro might want a closed pocket with a checkered web, as well as it's very common to have an open back that you see at the back of the glove right here. Some people might want to have just where one finger comes out, which we call an art back, as well as the fact there's also six-fingered gloves a player like Ozzie Smith wears, a shortstop for St. Louis Cardinals, which is very common as well. Some of the more uncommon things is some people don't like any padding in the bottom of the glove. That was Dave Winfield's favorite, so he could actually make this just like a complete pancake. Dick Schofield this morning wanted some padding taken out of the thumb area. Some people might want an actual glove. They like the glove, but they want it maybe a quarter inch, a little bit bigger. Taking care of the glove from when you buy it is important so that you're not going through gloves year in, year out. Getting the product doctor glove, rubbing it inside the palm so it works in the glove, you know, quite nicely. From there, the main thing you want to work in is the pocket here as well as the crease down here. How that glove's going to end up bending is basically how it's going to open and shut in the comfortableness of the glove. A lot of people who, you know, put the balls in the glove, as I was mentioning earlier, will fold the glove in like this and you get a big bulge in the bottom here. So it's really you gotta work, know where the crease is and bend it accordingly. As well as storing it, I mean, it's a lot of it's common sense as well. You don't want to be kicking it around the dugout, getting a lot of dirt in the glove. I mean, it's just gonna wear like a pair of shoes if you're gonna be kicking around on the in the dugout where you're playing on the school field in the gravel, etc.
This is a very special letter and I wanted to share it with you. It's from Terry in Lethbridge, Alberta. Dear Dr. J, thanks for all the nifty comic books and other stuff in the mail. Everybody in my family enjoys them. I was wondering if you could help me with a problem. Actually, it isn't my problem. It's my best friend's problem. My friend told me that he can't read very well. He's really embarrassed about it and doesn't want anyone else to know. What can I do to help? Well, Terry, there are lots of things you can do to help. For instance, pick a day and a time to meet your friend, find a good book or a magazine and read it together. It could be about the Blue Jays or something else you're both interested in. Help him with the words that he can't read or doesn't understand. It'll be fun for both of you. And try and get together once a week and read a different book each time. That way, it'll seem that each week is a new adventure.
For an answer to your questions about baseball or the Junior Jays, send a letter to Dr. J, care of Junior Jays, P.O. Box 6, Toronto, Ontario, M4A2M8.
I'm Tarzan Dan.
I'm Weird Al Yankovic.
It's coming. You gotta watch it.
Eric Gordian!
Tarzan Dan and Weird Al will be bringing you the YTV Achievement Awards, sponsored by Volvo Canada, 1994, driving for excellence. Industry Canada. And General Mills Fruit Roll-Ups. Fruit and fun rolled into one. The YTV Achievement Awards, Saturday, April 16th at 7:30.
Look who's here!
It's Cindy!
And a dog, Bogo!
So cute!
There's a new girl in town, and I'm so glad I found Cindy and Bogo! And Cindy loves walking Bogo around!
Bogo really walks!
Cindy and Bogo, so cool, so new! No other girl can do what you do! Cindy and Bogo really go, go, go!
She's the coolest girl I know!
Wow! There's a new girl in town, and I'm so glad I found Cindy and Bogo!
Battery not included. Cafe sold separately.
As you try new Kellogg's Rice Krispies Squares cereal, be warned, one taste is never enough. Yeah, you've tried a lot of cereals before, but none of them had the taste of Rice Krispies Squares in a totally new, totally crispy cereal. So if you want to scarf them down big time, remember, you're not alone. Kellogg's Rice Krispies Squares cereal, part of this complete breakfast. One taste is never enough.
Here's Makeup Beauty.
Makeup Beauty, I'm gonna make you beautiful.
Makeup, crayons, put lipstick there. Eyeshadow, nail polish, colorful hair.
Cool!
Some flowers here, some blush and then
wash it off and start all over again.
Makeup Beauty goes in the bathtub too.
Makeup Beauty, I'm gonna make you beautiful.
Makeup Beauty comes with her own skirt, makeup crayons, and comb, each sold separately.
Spring training camp in Dunedin is a very busy place. It's full of players and coaches and managers, and then there's all the fans trying to meet their baseball heroes. But there's another group of people who make spring training camp an exciting place, and that's the media. Television crews, radio and newspaper reporters, and sports photographers. They're in Dunedin to tell us how the Blue Jays prepare for the upcoming season. Our crew in Dunedin talked to one of the photojournalists.
I've always had a love for photography ever since I was a child, and my very first job when I was 15 years old was shooting photographs at an amusement park and then running them back and developing them in really quickly black and white. And from there it just kind of escalated into a passion, and I went to school at the University of Florida for a couple of years for photography, and it just kind of excelled into a lifelong love. This is a 300 millimeter 2.8 Canon lens, and this is just the beginning. This isn't a major sports lens, but it gets me to where I really need to go when it comes to just some basic sports shots. I do a lot of tennis shooting. I've shot some for the ATP tennis tour in Jacksonville, and I've shot some of the Amelia Island tennis tournament with Steffi Graf and Gabriella Sabatini. Golf, I've shot the TPC golf tournament. I've always wanted to shoot baseball, and I'm interested in baseball. And I'm not just shooting Toronto Blue Jays, but I'm also shooting the Orioles, and I shot the Phillies yesterday. I really love photography ever since I was growing up. If you find a passion in anything, music, sports, whatever, I think you should follow it, because I never knew I was actually going to be a photographer until I was about 20 to make a living. I never thought I'd do it as a lifetime love. I mean, this is like play for me. It's not even work. It's great.
1993, what a season for the Toronto Blue Jays. First, they won the American League East, then the American League pennant, And then we were on the edge of our seats. We just didn't know what was going to happen when the Jays won the World Series for a second year in a row. Yes, yes.
The 93 series featured two teams with powerful offenses. The Blue Jays were the first club in a century to have the top three finishers in the batting race, Olerud, Molitor, and Alomar. The Phillies featured a National League leading 877 runs, led by Lenny Dykstra, John Crook, and Darren Dalton. After wins in Game 1 and Game 3, the Jays won Game 4, the highest scoring game in series history, 15-14. Game 5 was all Curt Schilling as he shut the Jays out 2-0. The Blue Jays were leading the series 3-2 when they returned to Sky Dome for Game 6. After a fast start, the Jays fell behind when, with one out in the bottom of the ninth, Mitch Williams served up this pitch to Joe Carter. The rest, as they say, is history.
Who could forget that final inning of the World Series in 93? The country held its breath as Joe Carter's home run gave the Jays the World Series for a second year in a row. Joe talked to us about what that home run has meant to him.
Everywhere I went, people seemed to realize who Joe Carter was. And you know, it's kind of good and it's kind of bad because I lost a lot of my privacy. I think I'll pay the price for doing what happened in the World Series there. I can remember when I was as young as 7 or 8 years old, dreaming about things like that. And yeah, I'm here to tell you that dreams do come true, because that was definitely a big dream of mine. It came true. You still don't really believe it. Every time I watch a tape, you know, I keep looking for something different to happen. But every time I hit the ball in the ballpark, and I run on the bases the exact same way, so it doesn't change, and it really did happen. We had guys like Molitor coming over, Darnell Coles, Tony Fernandez coming back. I mean, those are guys who hadn't won a championship, and we had to be just as hungry for them as they were. And that was something that really kept us going, to see the way Molly played the whole year. Tony came back and had an incredible season once he did join us back. I mean, that's what kept us going, because we wanted to do the same thing for them. You know, they had that hunger and desire that we had the very first year. And I tell you what, the desire is still there.
It's time once again for Hubba Bubba's Junior J Trivia File. Who was in the on-deck circle when Joe Carter ended the 1993 World Series with a home run? The answer, Alfredo Griffin.
It's easy to get caught off base. Once in a while, everyone needs to talk to someone about their problems. Here are a couple of thoughts from a Junior J on important decisions that affected his life.
I was basically just living on from day to day. Existing on friends and just existing on, you know, drug use, alcohol, partying, friends and stuff. Not having any content at all. One of my friends had, they got stoned one night and they had went out. And as a result of this, they had to get their fingers cut off because they had frostbite. They got frostbitten. I was really shocked. I couldn't believe that the effect of drugs and alcohol had, that it affected his whole mental state. He didn't realize how cold it was outside. But that was a point when I said, you know, this is getting serious and I should back off. If you're a teenager out there and you are battling drugs and alcohol and you are battling these kind of pressures and social pressures, I would suggest that you go to, or do suggest that you go to a guidance counselor. Or I do suggest positive relations with your parents. Start speaking to them, start telling them exactly what you're doing and explain to them, this is what I'm involved with, can you help me? Ask for help. Don't feel too proud.
For all you Junior J members who want more of our Junior J's magazine, here's some good news. Coming soon in Sun newspapers and others right across Canada is a cartoon strip featuring the adventures of me, Dr. J, and the new Junior J's. And there's something else really exciting happening this summer. It's the Hubba Bubba Blowout Bubble Blowing Contest. That's right, the Hubba Bubba Blowout Bubble Blowing Contest. It's coming to an area near you. Watch for weekly updates on YTV this summer.
Go for 3, J's!
Good luck, Blue Jays.
I think they're gonna win it.
Blue Jays are number one!
Good luck.
Thank you for a great season.
Good luck, Jays!
guys.
Thank you, and I wish you good luck for this season.
Who is your favorite team?
Blue Jays.
Good luck, Blue Jays.
Thank you for last season and the year before. I was really happy that y'all won.
From Palm Harbor, Florida, go Jays, go!
YTV's Junior Jays TV Magazine will be right back.
It was just a dream.
They're real.
Then we'll oxycute them.
Pimple, there's a brand new oxy out there that means the beginning of the end of your zits in just 12 hours. New oil-free Oxy 5 lets you oxycute them. Oil-free, hassle-free, home-free.
Hi.
You look great.
Oxycute them.
Let the wacky wild games begin. They're
wacky wild, Kool-Aid style.
Kool-Aid soft drinks. So wacky.
So wild, wacky wild.
Bang.
Kool-Aid style.
Oh, awesome. Hey, you taste so wild.
Wacky wild.
Kool-Aid style.
Above the jungle, new battle birds.
Battle birds!
Airplanes become battling birds of prey. Heroic Sky Vice clenches his claws. Night Slayer shows his dark side.
Battle birds!
But Terror Dactyl is tearing up the sky. Part plane, part battle bird.
Attack Pack Battle Birds!
Unleash the beast!
Attack Pack Battle Bird vehicles, each sold separately only from Hot Wheels.
Fantastic flowers made by me.
What are you doing?
Making a bee.
Fantastic flowers made by me.
And now you can make sparkling magic flowers.
Fantastic flowers made by me.
Fantastic flowers flower making set comes with sparkling magic paper. Refill sold separately.
Pitching was a big part of the Blue Jays' success in 1993. During a game, pitchers use up a lot of energy. So when the game's over, they need a thirst-quenching drink and a high-energy snack.
All right, if you saw the last commercial, I was looking for snacks. I just couldn't find any. So I'm at my wit's end, and I thought I'd make my own snacks. And I have Dwayne Ward's recipe for super sliders. I'm going to show you how to make these. Okay, all you need is 3/4 cup of crushed graham crackers. Now, that's what crushed graham crackers look like. Uncrushed, and probably how you buy them, they look like this. So you gotta make them look like this, but they look like this, so you need this. Okay, so you get 3/4 of crushed graham crackers. Next step, you have 3/4 cup of granola. That's what that looks like. And it already comes looking like this, so we're gonna put it in. All right, no problem, I can cook. Okay, also, 2/3 cup of icing sugar, which is what this is, and it's kind of nice and white, we're gonna put it in. All right, next we need 1/4 cup of orange juice. That's what we have here. Vitamin C, right in there, 1/4 cup. And you just pour it in there, I guess, no problem. All right, next is 1/4 cup of coconut. I love coconut, it's my favorite part of the recipe. Coconut, all right. And 2 tablespoons of honey. So we get our measuring spoons, you get the 1 tablespoon and you do it twice with the honey. Okay, take 1 tablespoon. I don't know if they mean heaping or level, so we're just gonna get level. There we go, 1, and we're gonna get another 1, 2, all right? Then you get your hands over here, and you mix them up pretty good. Now, don't be afraid, it's just food. Get in there, mix it up, and you get a mix that looks a lot like this. Okay. So you get something like this, and you want to make little baseballs out of them. Oops. And then get our tray, put them right there. We get our colored sprinkles, which is what I have right here. And then you sprinkle a little bit of colored sprinkles on there. All right. And you eventually get something that looks a lot like this. I already made some. Check this out. Don't forget to put them in the fridge so that they harden.
The Dwayne Ward Super Slider. Very good for you and very tasty. Here we go. Oh, yeah.
It's a long way from Florida to British Columbia. But for the fans of the Blue Jays, distance doesn't matter. They're always excited about their team. In Coquitlam, British Columbia, we talked to Amy Larson about her favorite Junior Jays characters and her favorite Blue Jays.
It's nice to have just something in the mail that you can read and go, oh, wow. There's usually a character that relates to somebody, like I related to Ashley, and lots of people relate to other characters. Ashley, she's like kind of free-going, and like she knows what she's doing, and she makes herself nervous, but then she, when the time comes that she gets like a ball coming out or something, she makes the play nervously, but she gets it to the right place, and she knows what she's doing with it, so that's kind of like me. And I like Joe Carter because he's really good. He seemed so calm, but when he hit the winning home run in the World Series, he was all happy and he was jumping up and down, and it was just kind of, it was fun to see him like all excited. You should always be respectful to the players on your team, and if they make a bad play, you should always try to comfort them and not make them feel bad, and work your hardest and set your mind to it, and just do the best you can.
Junior Jay's Trivia File is brought to you by Hubba Bubba. Who was the only man to pitch a no-hitter as a Blue Jay? The answer, Dave Steve.
Spring training isn't just exercises, drills, and getting your equipment ready for the season. It's also baseball, real games, where Blue Jays, seasoned veterans, and young hopefuls play against the other teams in the major leagues. There's an entire season of exhibition games in Florida in a league called the Grapefruit League. This year, the first games of the Blue Jays spring training season were in Dunedin in early March. And here with her report is PJ Ashna.
Thanks, Dr. J. We're at Dunedin Stadium, the winter home of the Toronto Blue Jays. I wish it was my winter home, too. We're going to go inside, see what's going on, and even meet the voice of the Toronto Blue Jays. So come on, let's go.
It's an exciting time at Dunedin Stadium as the stands, playing field, and locker rooms are prepared for the game. Game, Blue Jay fans get their programs, souvenirs, and hot dogs. I got a chance to talk to Jerry Howarth and Tom Cheek, the voice of the Toronto Blue Jays.
Now, millions and millions of people get to listen to you on the air. What's it like to be live on the air?
It's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. I enjoy the preparation that goes to the broadcast itself. I enjoy calling the game. I enjoy working with Tom. And it's fun, especially at the Sky Dome, to be working before 50,000 fans every day.
It's an honor to be on the air. I think to be able to watch baseball, the great game that I grew up with as a youngster and was not good enough to continue playing, to be able to stay with the sport and to watch the best in the business play day after day, it's a tremendous honor.
Now, we see the players preparing for the season, but how do you prepare?
You've got to kind of retouch all the bases, I guess, and kind of update your mental notes that you keep on these fellows and find out what's happened to them during the offseason. A lot of them are youngsters. They played winter ball. Find out how that went.
Fastball is high, and it's one ball and one strike. Through two innings here in Dunedin, no score, the Blue Jays and Phillies.
Number 19, Kevin Stocker.
Dave Stewart, who has thrown just 17 pitches, 8 in the first inning and 9 in the second, will come out here in the third to face.
How do you remember all those details about the players?
Well, one thing people fail to remember is that Tom and I work with the team 8 months a year, so we're with them, we're like family. They become part of you, you're absorbed in your job 24 hours a day. And when you like something, I believe that your retention rate is a lot greater.
Has it been any different in the past 2 years?
I think 1992, when the Blue Jays won it for the first time, that was really, to me, the the win that was representative of having scaled the heights?
Well, the major highlights would be the two clubhouse celebrations in Atlanta and in Toronto winning the World Series. Those were great.
What advice would you give to young people who want to be sportscasters when they grow up?
Stay in school. Get an education. It starts right there.
Not everybody can get down to Florida to see the Blue Jays in spring training, but Blue Jays fans were itching to get an early start on watching their favorite team. And so, to give their fans a preview of the team for 1994 in the middle of March, the Blue Jays came home to Skydome.
I believe in life that you can do anything you want to do if you really want to do it. And I think a good tip for kids, if you really want to do something, you can do it, whether it's playing baseball or whether it's becoming a doctor or whatever. And just be very dedicated to it. Not only get yourself physically in shape and mentally prepared for it. And what we look for in kids is the desire to play, the need to play, the desire and want to play. So if you have all those qualities, then you certainly have an excellent chance to become a good ball player.
Well, that's it for our spring training edition of YTV's Junior Jays TV magazine. But remember, spring training is only the beginning of the baseball season. We'll be back in July with a special All-Star Break edition. And keep your eyes peeled for the all-new 94 spring edition of the Junior Jays magazine. You know, all the Jays talked about the fun they had playing baseball. But they also said that it was hard work and that they had to always keep trying and have a positive attitude. That's not just baseball. That's life. Oh, one last thing. Go, Jays, go!
I mean, I've always really taken a great deal from my mother and my father. They've always been my role models. They've always been the people that I've looked to find answers from. They've always been the people that have given me inspiration in what I'm trying to accomplish in life, in the game of baseball. No matter what, I could always go to them and get a solution to the problem. So they've always been the people that I've looked to.
The YTV Junior Jays TV Magazine has been brought to you by Hubba Bubba. This special program has been produced with the assistance of Health Canada and the World Series champions, the Toronto Blue Jays. Be on the lookout for the Junior Jays magazine comic, available from your neighborhood McDonald's restaurant. Next weekend, catch a happening night with Maren Cadell, West End Girls, plus Canada's newest crop of heroes. Tarzan Dan and Weird Al Yankovic co-host. Yeah, that's the YTV Achievement Awards, Saturday night at 7:30.
What's up? All right, you're back from school. It's not time to start relaxing. It's time for action. Put away that homework just for a little while and let Phil take you through the zone. We've got Samurai Pizza Cats in the house, Super Mario Brothers, Dennis the Menace, Captain Planet, Batman, and the Power Rangers every day of every week in the zone. Weekdays 3 to 6 on YTV. Ha-ha!
Hello, I'm Sandra Beach. With Block Parents in our communities, we can all feel more secure. Block Parents provide a safe place where any child can go for help. And Block Parents can help other people too. If you are sick, you can count on a Block Parent. Or if you're afraid. If you need help, just look for this sign. For more information about Block Parents, call 1-800-663-1134.
This is what we do best.
Let me tell you something, guys. This group has got passion.
Catwalk, tonight at 10 on YTV.
He's a globe-trotting bear with a sense of adventure. And he wants you to come along for the ride.
Tour the world from the comfort of your own home with Rupert. Next on YTV.